Now, some of you may remember President Ronald Reagan's 1981 appointment of Jean Kirkpatrick as U.S. ambassador to the UN was not met with universal approval. Never before had a woman held that position, and this woman happened to be a member of the opposition party. Nevertheless, President Reagan chose her as his envoy to this global institution and included her in his cabinet. It didn't take long for Ambassador Kirkpatrick to prove her mettle. Asked about the most significant change she made at the UN, she replied succinctly, "We've taken down our kick me sign." And President Donald Trump's appointment of Nikki Haley as ambassador to the UN also was unorthodox, not because she's a woman, but because she was a Southern governor from outside the Beltway who would be the first Indian American to serve as ambassador and cabinet minister. She too quickly proved her mettle. Representing the UN at the UN, the United States at the UN, Ambassador Haley, like Ambassador Kirkpatrick, has become the nemesis of America's enemies. She's led efforts to increase the pressure on North Korea. She has led the way in explaining the fatal flaws of the Iran nuclear deal. She has called out Iran and Russia for facilitating the carnage in Syria and telling the truth about the criminal narco state of Maduro's Venezuela. And she has courageously defended Israel at the UN. Ambassador Haley is like Ambassador Kirkpatrick was, authoritative, eloquent, and elegant. It's a potent cocktail, often and not easily mixed. Ambassador Kirkpatrick, who passed away 12 years ago, would be very pleased and encouraged to see such a kindred spirit representing the US at the UN today. Though the two statesmen came from very different backgrounds, they are both really inspiring examples of the American dream pursued and fulfilled. Ambassador Kirkpatrick was born in rural Oklahoma, the daughter of a dollar-a-day oil rig laborer. She had brains and the determination to put them to productive use. Ambassador Haley is the daughter of Sikh immigrants from the Punjab. Her father became a biology professor at a community college in South Carolina. Her mother, a sixth-grade social studies teacher and the founder of a clothing company. Her family encountered prejudice, they overcame it, and they relentlessly instilled in Ambassador Haley a sense of gratitude and pride to live in this wonderful country. She is an individual with a distinct American voice and a precise moral compass, which is why we can think of no better recipient for FDD's Jean J. Kirkpatrick Statesmanship Award than Ambassador Haley. So today, Ambassador Haley is going to be interviewed by my good friend and close colleague, Cliff May. Cliff serves as FDD's president, and he had the privilege of working with Ambassador Kirkpatrick and other visionaries to establish FDD just after the attacks of 9/11. Indeed, it was only 2 weeks before 9/11 when Ambassador Kirkpatrick pulled together a bipartisan group of policymakers and philanthropists with a warning that the terrorism being directed against American allies and American interests abroad would one day come to its shores. And 2 weeks later, 9/11 happened, and everybody got together shortly after that and acknowledged Jean's prescience. She saw the need for a think tank like FDD focused on the threat. And earlier this year, Cliff wrote a wonderful column about both Ambassador Kirkpatrick and Ambassador Haley, and I think it's available, so please take a look at that. Ambassador Haley, on behalf of FDD and everybody here, thank you for your service to our country, and we look forward to hearing from you.
Thank you so much. This is very kind. Thank you.